I still have a dream.
Yes.
It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream.
Yes.
I have a dream that one day,
yes,
this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
Yes.
I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream. And so let freedom ring from the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire. Let freedom ring from the mighty mountains of New York. Let freedom ring from the heightening Alleghenies of Pennsylvania. Let freedom ring from the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado. Let freedom ring from the curvaceous slopes of California. But not only that, let freedom ring from Stone Mountain of Georgia. Let freedom ring from Lookout Mountain of Tennessee. Let freedom ring from every hill and mole hill of Mississippi, from every mountainside. Let freedom ring, and when this happens, and when we allow freedom ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
I have to say that America is a great country in the universe. It has the place of the Vishuddhi Chakra, which is the center of responsibility and discretion. And they have been so responsible so far. They have given such noble ideas of democracy and of freedom and all those things which are really all belonging to God's ideas. And when they talk of all these things, we must know that there is something much more that they can give to the whole world. So many saints are born in this country because they realize that this is the country where they'll be able to prosper better into their spirituality. So it is a very great responsibility of Americans to understand that we have had great leaders, we have had great noble ideals, we have got great saints living here. So many are anxious to come down here. Only thing what we have to do is to establish within ourselves our spirit and to be ready and prepared for this great, tremendous work that is going to come now. And this is what the world has to do. If emancipation of the humanity has to take place, it has to take place only from inside out and not outside in. Another thing I would like to tell, that the danger is not from outside for America, not from anywhere else, it is from within themselves. So be careful. We have to be careful about ourselves, the way we are destroying. When we say what's wrong, we go headlong into our destructions. Human beings should not take freedom as abandonment, but freedom to enjoy completely and fully. The freedom that takes you to your destruction is not freedom. And the right idea of freedom must be taken, and people should know that freedom, ultimate freedom, is when you become your own master. When there are no habits, when you cannot be dominated by anything, you are above everything. That's the freedom you have to achieve. And that is why people talked long time back in this country about freedom. They helped all the countries to get their freedom, and now it is their job to get them their own freedom within themselves, so that others will also follow. May God bless you all.